a hairstyle. So we got the Caucasian Wildcat. These are cat breeds I'm not familiar with. The Crete Wildcat looks really interesting. I don't know about the Palace Cat. That looks weird. That looks weird as fuck. Refresh. Did something happen to stream? Did stream go down for anyone else or just me? Oh, and the bot quit working. Did it? Oh, well, fuck it did. Hold on. Give me a second. I'm sorry. It didn't go down for me. Why does it gotta be like this? I'm sorry about that. That's probably my cue to go. That's probably shit saying, all right, go. Bye. Aww. I just wanted to look at these cats real quickly. Okay, we got leopard, cheetah, African gold. These look pretty. The African golden cats, they look pretty cool. Sand cat, jungle cat, black-footed cat. Aw, these are so cute. I think this is a lynx.
You ready?
The first one is a lynx.
Good boy, Howie.
Oh, there is a bobcat. Always gets me in. Why does it sound so human?
Good morning. How are you?
So it basically said that the idea of having a serval as a pet is a terrible idea. We have 18 surrendered servals because people thought they would make a good pet. That's what I always think when I see that famous one, Glad I'm Not Crazy. Would any of these make good pets? Looks cuddly. There's a lady that's a wild and animal transporter, and she has a serval for a pet, and he's thriving. But she also knows how to take care of them.
So who's here, Will?
That's what I think. I think if you don't know how to take care of something, then it won't work. Deputy Waldo on it. What's up, Waldo? Thank you so much for that. I appreciate it.
How are you, Safari?
We didn't crash. We just needed a refresh. Thank you, guys. You guys are awesome.
Good boy, buddy.
He has the tippy tappies.
Good morning, hello. Good morning. Ready for breakfast? You a chatting? Good girl.
Oh, she ran away with her food. More. She said, bye, bitch.
Good morning, Maja. You ready?
So much chaotic energy. Is this the bobcat? Which one is this? Is this another lynx?
Good morning, Mia.
Oh, her name's Mia.
Look at her ears.
Look at her ears. So she's gorgeous.
So polite.
Very polite. Flappa. Hi, welcome back.
Hey, Tashi.
How's your morning going sideways, or your evening, or your night? It's currently 8:22 a.m. for me.
Good morning, Violet.
So that's Violet. We stay away from Violet.
Who's here, Will?
Hey! Who is he?
It's your cousin, Carlton, don't you remember? When you two were little, people used to think you were twins. You looked exactly alike.
Oh, well, guess some things never change.
How's it going there, Will?
Yeah, it's going all right, man.
Ah, Malcolm X.
Yeah, he's sort of my hero.
Well, he was a great man. I don't know if I'd call him my hero exactly.
Oh, really? Who are your heroes?
Well, my dad. And Bryant Gumbel, he's darn good.
Oh, my, yes.
See, they brought your tuxedo.
That's a really neat tux, isn't it, Will?
Oh, yes, it's definitely the cat's meow.
Wait till we come downstairs in those tuxes. People may not think we're twins, but I'll bet they think we're brothers.
You know, I don't think you have to worry about anybody mistaking you for a brother.
Touche. This is going to be great. Your first formal dinner. And tomorrow I'll introduce you to the gang. Maybe we'll play a set of tennis or two.
Oh,
Oh, yes, this is going to be wild.
Oh, boy.
Who's here, Will?
I'm about to go take a shower.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Oh, and, you need to, figure out your tenant.
Come on, don't start. It's early in the morning, yo.
What? I didn't say nothing, but you know she gonna keep trying you.
She ain't gonna have a chance to, yo.
How you figure that?
I mean, first of all, this.
I do have to go to work, and I can't protect you all day and night.
Seriously, you think I need protection from her?
You think I'm trying to protect you from her?
Ain't that what you just said, though?
No. I'm trying to protect you from your damn self.
Because
if you mess
take
up,
time,
that's your ass. Okay?
Don't worry. I'm coming.
No, you're not. Because if you come, I ain't gonna get to work. Get up.
I am up.
Oh, damn. Mm-hmm.
Yo! You just gonna close the door?
Yep, it's locked.
And you locked the door?
Yep.
All right. Bet you Deja open her door for me. Too soon?
Way too damn soon.
You open that door, though.
Get your ass in here.
That's what I thought.
I'm about to take a
shower. You need to fill your bottle?
Yeah, I'm coming.
Oh, and,
I know it was.
You need to,
you just looked at it.
Right. Figure out your tenant.
Come on, don't start. It's early in the morning, yo.
What? I didn't say nothing, but you know she gonna keep trying.
Wait, what happened, Raymond? I'm so sorry. I don't know what was said. What were we saying? Never mind, too. What you like or your style. What do you mean by that? I don't know what your question was, Raymond. I'm sorry. I missed that. My stream restarted. I missed some questions. Oh, hi, Sin. I restarted the bot, by the way, Sin. Oh, and the bot quit working, huh? Oh, my bad. Boy. Is everything working good? Aw, when a doggy, that's a cute doggy, cutie. She finally gets to see them again. Aw. I really like this gray one, and I already know what it looks like. Adorable. Aw, when they want. That's adorable. It's a border collie, if I'm not mistaken. Gravy wasn't sure about the meaning. But the orange cat loves the doggo. Sorry, I mean, what do you mean by what's my style? This is about the time I wake up to go to work at 11. Damn. What do you know about this? Nah, Raymond, you're fine. Sometimes you guys are gonna have to repeat questions to me, and I hope you guys don't think I'm ignoring you or I'm mad at you. I just want you guys to know, the more I grow, the less I know. And you might need to repeat some stuff. I'm not like that. I don't ignore people. And if I do ignore you, chances are it's probably for the best. But thank you. I just don't know what you mean by what's my style. This is about... Honestly, I'm surprised I'm still up. I might make myself some breakfast. I might sneak some breakfast. I didn't eat yesterday, so I owe myself something. I'm not trying to piss off people. Oh, I don't know. I don't know. I guess surprise me. Everybody has a different style. I like that gray cat. I want it. That's adorable. I like this song. I have it on my phone, actually, for anybody that's interested. You've been gone not for too long, but it feels like ages to me. Oh. I'm going to be honest. I don't know what you mean by style either. I think he meant, like, art style. He mentioned wanting to draw me as a Pokemon card trainer.
Okay, don't be surprised if this happens for you after you watch this video. For those of you who are new here, this is a collective reading, meaning it's meant for a large group of people. When I'm doing a collective reading, basically what that means is I'm sending my little receptors out there and getting a huge energy pull of what society is going through in general right now. If you notice, a lot of people will go through similar things at similar times, like during a full moon, during
listen, the full moon was horrible.
Alignment of planets. But if it doesn't resonate, don't take it. Another one may resonate for you, or maybe my content's just not for you, and that is totally okay.
My rainbow fluorite, beautiful. There are styles for Pokemon cards. My thing is everybody has their own drawing style. Like what's trademarked for you, good or bad.
So we have the Six of Cups. When I see the Six of Cups, this usually represents
your
past.
That's what he means.
Now we're gonna clarify this because obviously this is very open-ended. You know, the Six of Cups can represent thinking too much on the past or your past coming back, someone from the past returning. But let's see what the next cards are to see what this truly means. So with the Four of Cups, I feel like there was a rejection here. Like maybe you are holding on to a past moment where you feel like you weren't chosen or you weren't put as a priority, or maybe this
that
person
never
just
happened,
straight up
so
rejected you or ghosted
patterns.
You, and it still lingers. But what's really interesting is the Hanged Man here, which talks about seeing things from a new perspective. And what's really interesting is since I pulled the Six of Cups first, it almost makes me feel like this person who rejected you may try to come back in, or maybe
rejected.
You'll just find that clarity within yourself. But I do feel like if this person does come back in, you're recognizing your worth now. It feels like with the Eight of Swords here, you were kind of like keeping yourself bound up by your own thoughts. Like you allowed people like this to take advantage of you because you were putting yourself at a lower value, but now you understand your value, especially with the Justice card here. It's like you are victorious in this situation.
Okay, what?
Don't be surprised if this happens.
Good morning, guys. This is a PSA for Brian Anderson for the third time. If your name is Brian Anderson and you live in Anaheim, California, I'd stick around if I were you. A very beautiful, kind, and extremely wealthy woman DM'd me on Instagram about a week and a half ago.
What do you mean?
And told me that her husband...
Are you talking about the tarot card readings, Sin? Hi, Swag in the Bag. How you doing? So one thing that confuses me about tarot. What about it? You mentioned... Okay, so if you want me to break it down for you, Sin, I could break it down for you. You talking about upright and reversed? Reversed and right side up? Right side up will... It depends. Like, pick a card and I'll look it up for you. Because every card is something different.
So this house here is called La Casa de los Tubos and it's located in Monte...
I just got the worst phone call of my fucking life and I'm coming on TikTok. I might scream, I might cry. I don't know what the fuck I'm going to do, but I can't. I got a call from my SVC. If you don't know what an SVC is, it's my Special Victims Council. It's my lawyer. And if you don't know why I need a lawyer, it's because in 2019 I was sexually assaulted by a sergeant first class.
Hi.
In the parking lot of my barracks.
Hi.
So I was just trying to go home.
Good morning.
I've been fighting for years to get just the smallest crumb of justice because they fumbled the bag once and then they were like, oh, sorry, we fumbled the bag. Let's try to help you again. Just for her to call me and tell me that they fumbled it so fucking hard twice. Like, why fucking put me through it twice? If you're just gonna fumble so fucking hard and then close my case, call it quits. That's it. So you want to know what the punishment for sexually assaulting a 19-year-old PV2 when you're a 30-something-year-old sergeant first class in the United States Army is? It's not what they tell you. It's not court-martial. It's not board for separation. No, because if you're cool enough with everybody on fucking top, you get an Article 15 found guilty of fraternization, which means that both parties consented. You find somebody guilty of fraternization, you're finding me guilty of fraternization saying that I wanted it. But not guilty of sexual misconduct. Not guilty of the actual sexual assault. Then, you get the option. Do you want a court-martial, or do you just want to leave?
Alright, I'm sorry, I wasn't trying to down the mood. I was trying to understand, because that looked serious. It says Army Strong, Military and Army, and stuff like that. What's a card that you would like to have me look up? It doesn't even matter. What's the difference between upright and reversed in tarot cards? Perfect. Boom. I got you. Is what decides if it is right. So actually, it's not about what decides it. It's about how you shuffle it, Sin. So if you notice, they'll split. They do a thing called splitting the deck. And what you do is you initially break your, if it's like, let's say it's a fresh deck, meaning brand fucking new right out of box, right? You break it in half, as equal as you can get it, and you split it, and then what happens is you fold it inwards, not outwards, or you could do it reversed, but I mean, you want the back part of the card outside. You don't want the, what it's supposed to be on the out, you know? So basically, you split the deck. You break inward, and then some of the cards will actually be placed upside down. And then what they do is they'll do like a shuffle motion, and whatever cards fly out, that's the card that Spirit picked out for you initially. So what is, I'm going to read the actual term. Horsey escape, that's bullshit, people suck, yeah. It confuses me is what decides. Okay, but the thing is that it's not about deciding. So basically it says a reverse card is usually considered a card that is upside down to you, not the person you're doing the reading for. And an upright card is considered, hold on. I don't want a video. The upright is just upright. But they do have meanings. They do have meanings. So actually, not shopping, let's go to images. So basically, for instance, the fool card has not come out, has been coming for, like, when I get readings or when I see, like, the collective readings, which is just a large collective of people, it's not me, it's for just me. That's why they always say whatever resonates with you, take it, and whatever doesn't, don't take it. Like, it's not always for you. So basically, upright is meaning innocence, freedom, originality, adventure, travel, foolishness, carelessness, idealism, youth, spontaneity, lack of commitment, and new beginnings. But if the Fool card is reversed, it means recklessness, carelessness, negligence, stupidity, distraction, apathy, irrationality, lack of fun, and hope for faith. Hope or faith. So basically, you don't have... They tell stories with tarot cards, Sin. And basically, depending on the order of what cards come out and the upright or reversed sighting of it, it will kind of determine what Spirit's trying to tell you. I've been getting the High Priestess. I've been getting Queen and Queen of Cups. So basically, if you get the High Priestess upright, which I've actually been getting it kind of either or. No, I know, but I'm just saying that what the upright and the reversed is what I'm saying. They have meanings. So it's basically how you break the deck, if to put it into short terms for tarot.
What is this? And tell me you.
I'm trying to
a
find.
A lot of people are asking if I chose to work at 50.
I'm trying to find a video where they show actually breaking the deck and shuffling it so that you can see what I'm talking about.
So something crazy happened, and Dwayne The Rock Johnson messaged me on Instagram. He said, "Hello, dear fan." I said, "Hi, Dwayne." He said, "How are you doing?" And I said, "I'm okay. How are you?" And he said, "I'm doing good. Where are you from?" I said, "Louisiana. You?" No, sorry, Dwayne. I didn't want to tell you my real... I'm from Massachusetts. He said, "Hayward, California." I said, "Nice." So something crazy happened, and Dwayne The Rock Johnson messaged me on Instagram.
Nah, that's
He fake. Said, "Hello, dear fan."
What's going on here? You got some...
You're my baby. Let's just not do this right now.
You need to leave. I can't even believe what you're doing now.
I've lost over 200 pounds.
Your fiance is more obsessed with your new Stanley Cup.
What are you doing?
Wow.
Nothing?
Sound check.
All right, look. Pay attention to what she just did with her cards.
Book private reading. Go to TaurusThirdEyeTarot.com.
See, look.
I'm having a download that there is going to be a car accident, and there's going to be a karmic, and there's going to be a masculine. But this isn't just a regular karmic masculine dynamic. This is someone that's either going to be a friend or a family member. And this is how the truth actually comes all the way out.
I don't like this. I'm getting bad energy. Did you see it, Sin? Do I need to go backwards?
Yeah. Someone's going to sneak away at night under the moon. To go do something sexual, and they're going to get injured. Tell me more.
This doesn't have anything to do with me. This can't.
Something that was lied about.
It still makes no sense.
Didn't I say a friend or a family member?
What exactly is it that you're asking, Sin? What do you mean by, like, what is it, how does it determine if it's upright or whatever? I need to find a better video where you can see it. Basically, you split the deck. And sometimes people will have, like, the right half, for instance. They'll put it upside down. So half of the deck will be reversed. And half of the deck will be upright. And then you shuffle them so that they're in... It's basically like when you do a magic trick. Like, think of a card trick, right? No, yeah. So what is it that you're not understanding? I'm trying to... Oh, when it is drawn? Okay. So it depends on what kind of reading you're doing, because there's different... Like, everybody's different. Sometimes they'll pick three cards. They'll be like... It'll be a very short reading, right? It's the then, the now, and what's coming, if that makes sense. Like, do I have your attention at that? Like, does that make sense? Okay. Hopefully Discord doesn't show up. I will go on the stream chat. I gotta pee.
Okay.
Okay, what's up?
So, what I don't understand is when it is drawn into the hand
of the dealer. Like
Yeah, is it when it's drawn into the hand of the dealer and it's upside down in their hand? Or is it, like, there's some people who draw and then they'll immediately put it on the table. Is it when it's facing them or when it's facing you? You see what I mean?
Okay, yeah. Like, so there's multiple ways I can answer that. So, okay, let's go, like, real old school, like, gypsy style, right? those are the OG readers. They're the tarot readers, you know, the not the crystal ball, yeah, but the ones that are in the little tents with the, it's kind of giving off gypsy vibes. All right.
The
so,
ones that are in the carts on the side of the road, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You see, like, you knew exactly what I was talking about. All right, so the OGs, not the new, now they have, like, little shops and stuff like that, which is cool, or, like, they're in the corners of, like Salem, Massachusetts, like, little shops, like, which is fine. So they'll break the deck, and like I said, some of them, I think, like, a lot of them will split, like, so, like, the left side will be upright, and the right side will be reversed, and then they'd shuffle the deck, and then sometimes you have those tarot readers that will flail out all the cards, and you pick, right? It's just, it depends on the person you're dealing with. Then you'll have the people that are like, okay, we're gonna do three cards, the then, like, past, present, future. Basically, that's the easiest way to describe it. They will put it, so after they shuffle, which there are reverse cards in the deck and there are upright cards in the deck, so what they'll do is they'll pick the three cards random, like they'll fling out, which I'm hoping you can find videos, like I'll play them so you can see what I'm talking about.
I mean, I've seen all the styles because Hollywood itself has done multiple versions of that in multiple movies.
Hollywood's also fake, in my opinion. But, so, the one you're talking about, all right, we'll do the cards on the table. So, we'll do the past, present, and future, basically. You put the three cards down, and then they'll flip them. Or, they'll do the deck style, which is the one that I've been seeing a lot on TikTok, where they'll be folding the deck, as I think is what they call it, which is just shuffling. They'll fold the deck, and they'll be like, spirit, you know, for the TikTok collective or for the collective, like, what's going to happen in their relationship, what's happening in their life. It just really depends on what the dealer is trying to channel out. Is it a love reading? Is it a, you know, a future reading? Is it about something that they need to be warned about? It really just depends. Let's just say, for the sake of argument, it's a love reading. I like the three card ones where if they're going to put it on the table, like you're asking, that you would just flip them. And it would be, depending on the person would be like, okay, so they're reading it from their perspective, not your perspective. They're reading it to you at, like, let's say I'm reading it to you. So I flip and I get the Fool in reverse as the first card. If you know what the meaning behind the card is, then you already have a start to your story. All right, that was in the past. Okay, then I flip and I get the Queen of Cups upright, which is you're in your power. You're in your energy. You can't be bothered. You're in your elegancy. Like, you should know what the card means. You basically have told me you know what it means, so.
And then, yeah, I know what it means, but the thing that confuses me is when it hits the table.
Yeah. So basically, let's say you're the one that's doing the reading, you would read it as it's presented to you, not them.
Okay, that's what I was confused about. Like, yeah, that was the whole thing.
Yeah.
Like, do I read it because it's their fortune as it lands on the table facing them or facing me?
I want to say, based off what I've, like, gathered from watching the videos, that it would be from your perspective as the reader and not so much the perspective of them. But, I mean, that is an interesting term because then that means it just flips. So, like, if it's reversed to you, it'd be upright for them.
That's what I was concerned about, because the thing is, it makes me think, like, if I'm doing the reading.
There are fake readers. My bad. I didn't mean to cut you off.
But what I was saying is, like, I'm trying to pause the stream, so I'll quit talking to myself.
I think that's what was going on.
But what I was confused about is, like, when it hits the table, mm-hmm, since I'm reading their fortune instead of mine, wouldn't I read it from their angle instead of from mine?
You could. I mean,
that would make more sense to me.
Well, yeah. But the thing is that, another thing from the authentic ones, again, if you didn't notice, did you notice I skipped a few of them and you could just kind of tell I wasn't interested or it didn't really read to me? Even though I'm not near them, I can tell this isn't for me. Like, even when I start listening to some of them, because I get, you know, curious, and I'm like, okay, well, you never know. I might have bad energy reading on this person, but it has nothing to do with the way they look. It's just the energy I'm feeling from it. I'm like, this has nothing to do with me. I don't care. And I'm not even trying to be mean. It's just my intuition, or I'm very intuitive, so I get those vibes where it's like, this isn't for me. Or this doesn't resonate with me. This has nothing to pertain towards me. One, a lot of the videos I've noticed, they'll be like, oh, someone's gonna, you know, you were married to somebody or you're divorcing somebody. And I'm over here just like, first of all, I'm in a weird situation, but I'm not married at all. I'm not in a position to even be cheated on. So, you know, just because in my head, if I find out that the person that I like and I want to be with is like having sex with somebody else, there's a reason why I would have high energy and why, let's not even get into it. I don't want to sound like a psycho on stream, but there's a reason why I'd have a right to be mad. Congrats on your your hippo. But yeah.
Hippowdon.
Your hippow. That's what I'm gonna call it. But yeah, there's a reason why it's an autopilot thing as well, where I'll just be like, oh, this isn't for me. Like, for her, it says this will be a friend or family member, karmic, may pass away, masculine. Yeah, like, I'm getting energy from it, and I don't like it.
If I slept with someone and they immediately passed away, I'd assume I'd have death dick. Just saying.
Or you can have bomb dick, and it just exploded inside of her. She couldn't handle it. It was like a firework went off in there. That's dangerous. Imagine you had a firework in your vagina, though. Like, that's... ugh. You know?
Because, baby, you're a firework.
That is what went through my head. At least I'm not the only one that was fucking thinking that.
The only reason I went to that is because I recently watched The Interview again.
Yeah. Good lord.
And it made me think of Kim Jong-un in the movie blowing up in the helicopter.
I'm shaking my head. I just want you to know that. Like,
also, I really loved that actor who played Kim Jong-un singing the song.
Very badly, but yeah.
The only reason I liked it is because his accent. I was just like, that's great. Imagine her singing that in that accent.
Good lord. I already sing Simlish, so. And Katy Perry actually sang Simlish for Sims 4, so. The more you know. But all I keep thinking is, do you ever feel like a plastic bag? Like a plastic bag. That's what's repeating in my head at the moment. And I hate you for it.
I do feel like a plastic bag over my head. Anyway.
It's just, do you ever feel like a plastic bag? Like a plastic bag? Like a plastic bag? That really spoke to me. Go eat your cookie, baby. I gave him a Christmas cookie, but yeah. So, apparently somebody's going to get in a car accident. But again, I wanted to be, like, specific when it comes to these readings. I'm not highlighting until this moment right now. A lot of the videos, you'll notice that not all of them have soulmate hashtags or twin flames. So, that is why I have bad vibes. And I really do hope that this person doesn't get in a car accident and is not trying to have sexual relations with somebody, because I would really hate to turn him into a female. I will dead do some psychotic shit. I don't play about that shit. You know? I just don't. Yeah, I mean, that's like, if Ellie cheated on you, wouldn't you want to cut her nipples off and feed them to a turtle? A snapping turtle? A very angry, hungry snapping turtle?
I am just over here imagining that I would not like to force an animal to become a domer, but okay.
Well, I mean, it doesn't know what you're feeding pepperoni nipples to her, or him, you know?
I wouldn't know what, never mind.
Yeah. I wouldn't know the gender of a turtle, especially a snapping one. Maybe.
Well, that's not what I was talking about, but okay.
When you claim a person, it's hard.
I think I'm more lenient on that, considering the fact I am open to having extra people in my relationship if the other person wants.
Exactly. But I'm not. And once I physically, mentally, emotionally claim somebody, it doesn't work like that. And until the day you tell me, I don't have feelings for you anymore, I don't want to be with you, I'm not trying to work on nothing, like, yeah. Or until I lose feelings, or whatever the case may be. I don't like to be played with. It's basically like I don't have feelings for people or try to progress with people to get played with. And I feel like people be fumbling me a lot and playing games with me too much. And I don't fuck with it. And I feel like I have every right to feel that way.
We need a positive association with the kennel, so we're going to make sure that good things happen in the kennel. So here I sprinkled food all over the kennel. She's going to want to go in and eat her food. Here I put water, two essentials. I put both essentials in her kennel, so she's going to want to go in there. She's going to get what she needs, and then she's going to start to go in there on her own. As you can see, the door stays open, so she can make her own choice whether to go in or not, but if she goes in, she's not trapped. Now, before every time we go in the kennel, we're going to do a potty break, and every single time we come out of the kennel, we're going to do another potty break. Now, we want to make sure we're providing a good balance between mental exercise, physical exercise, enrichment, and rest. Now, in between kennel times, we're going to be doing short sessions of mental exercise, physical exercise, and enrichment. It has to stay short.
Tiny.
Because these are tiny little puppies, and they actually need 16 to 18 hours of rest per day. So, in all of these clips, I've done something that benefits her either mentally, physically, or both. Now, keep in mind, these exercises are going to change. We're not going to do the same thing every time she's out of the kennel. We're also going to make sure that we're only...
I'm confused.
What?
Apparently Wednesday. Oh, never mind.
Wednesday what?
And I misread this. It said continue watching instead of what I thought it said.
Oh. Only doing two or three of these exercises and then kennel rest. Two or three exercises and then kennel rest. Now you're going to see that I sleep with the kennel on the bed. I do this for about three or four nights, depending on her, and we go from there. Now you're going to notice that when I do actually close the kennel and latch it shut, she's not freaking out. She's processing it, but at this point, she knows the drill. She has a positive association with the kennel, and she knows that every time she goes in the kennel, that does not mean I'm going to be leaving. So she thought about for a bit, and then she goes to self-soothe, relax, and eventually fall asleep. I understand kennel training can be hard and extremely frustrating for some, but the more you know, the better you're off, and the easier it'll
be. Seven star ditto?
First things first, we need a positive...
Aw, that fucking puppy was adorable. Why my family mad I testified my aunt for offing my little cousin? Wow.
What do you guys think of this theory?
Bro, I don't give a fuck who you are. If my mom murdered somebody, I'm testifying against her. Mm-mm. Oh, this is the guy that
19, I was broke. Like, dead broke. I had less than $100 to my name, and my rent was $1,000, and my girlfriend at the time came to me and said, how are we gonna pay rent? Because I'm broke, and you broke. Neither of us had any kind of ideas, so we sat together and we prayed. Quick side note for the new people. I've been a professional fighter since September of 2017. 2 days after that conversation, my manager called me and offered me a last-minute fight in Miami for $500. Reluctantly, I took it. That was the lowest I've ever been paid for a fight at the time, but I needed to pay rent. Day before I left to Miami, I sat down in the bathroom and told my girlfriend, when I get back, we having a baby and we getting married. Just like that. At that exact same time, I took her birth control pill she was on and flushed them down the toilet. Again, dead broke, $500, had no idea what I was doing, but I believe in God. I paid my rent, I won my fight, and I started doing Postmates to make extra money. I took the extra money and I bought a ring with it. It was like $500. 2 days before Christmas, I proposed. A day after Christmas, she got pregnant. The same day we found out we was pregnant, I got a call from my manager and I earned a six-figure contract from my last fight. Fast forward to February, I won my first fight, and I used half of my money to buy my fiance a birthday gift. The birthday gift I bought her was a trip to China, and we was gonna go to Disneyland in China. But as we all know, March of 2020 is when the pandemic started. I was crushed to tell her that we had to cancel her birthday trip because of a pandemic. So we prayed together. 2 days into the quarantine, my friend told me about this app called TikTok. I started posting and I had no idea. When I say no idea, I had no idea that it was gonna take me where it took me.
I forgot to mention, in August of 2021, I lost my six-figure contract and I was broke again. But I prayed. Less than a year later, I signed a brand deal through TikTok that paid me just as much as I was going to get paid with the rest of my six-figure contract.
Fast forward to today, we are married with two children, and we are doing very well financially. This is the part where the good news come in. I got two. Number one, thanks to y'all's support, in less than 2 years, I went from somebody randomly making TikToks to being booked to be on one of the shows I've been watching since I was 18 years old. The React channel, People vs. Food, on YouTube. That's why I've been making a lot of food reviews. So the new people that come over here are going to be like, oh, he already got a full playlist of food reviews? Yeah, I do. Number two, I have not told my wife this yet, so she finding out with y'all. We going to China for her birthday this year. It's crazy how much can change in 3 years. God bless you guys. Have an amazing day. Thank you for listening.
I love that.
Quick story time.
Which zodiac sign all of these signs wanted to marry? The question was kiss, kill, marry. This is the marry portion. Let's go. Up first, we have Aquarius. Aquarius wanted to marry Sagittarius. No shocker there. Leo was falling closely behind. This is not a surprise at all. Aquarius did not want to marry Cancer. I've mentioned this before, Aquarius and Cancer have low-key beef. The beef is very, very strong. Up next, we have Aries. Of course, they also wanted to marry Sagittarius. Aries, Sagittarius might be my favorite couple in the zodiac. Aquarius was very close behind. Aries really did not want to marry Pisces. As an Aries, I can agree. Up next, we have Cancer. They really wanted to marry Taurus with Scorpio following behind.
Interesting.
Cancer was like, absolutely no Libras, absolutely no Leos, and absolutely no Sagittarius, please. Jesus. Up next, we have Gemini. They really, really, really wanted to marry Sagittarius. And then after that, it was Aries. No. This one was kind of a shock. Geminis do not want to marry Leos. Geminis are like, I love the two.
Sin.
No, I didn't.
No, I haven't cooked or had anything to eat yet, Raymond. Why? So they're going off the kill, marry, like kiss, kill, marry kind of thing for the astrological signs. And it was basically saying that my sign wanted to really marry Sagittarius, which sounds fucking stupid to me because I've not met one Sagittarius that I was like, oh my God, you know? Yeah, so, and then it said Aries was next, which I've come across no Aries that I fucking want to marry. And yeah, it said abso-fucking-lutely not, will not marry a Leo. Which I kind of agree that Geminis and Leos, at least in my opinion, from a female to male perspective, are better as friends than in a relationship. Personally, for our well-beings, better as friends.
Even it's then. That time of the day again, isn't it? Yeah, where you little slags get your jollies off to me because you enjoy my misery as a tattoo artist. Yeah, you do. You do. So, I'm going to tell you about one of the weirdest requests I've ever had to do as a tattoo artist because I always get asked, what is the weirdest tattoo you've done?
I didn't feel like watching the whole video. Cancers, I think, would have been right after.
Which zodiac sign all was kind of a shock of the two chaos signs, but the other chaos sign, absolutely not. For Leo, who they wanted to marry, was a very tight race. Libra did pretty close behind Pisces. They made a decision to marry Sagittarius. Next, we have Cancer. They really wanted to marry Taurus.
Oh, you were really like Taurus. You don't pay attention to what game. I'd rather not talk about food unless someone's trying to try to feed me, personally.
Introducing my...
Here's my list of things in Japan that would send Americans into a coma. First things first, trash separation. And when you move, your ward gives you an entire calendar of how you're going to separate your trash. Because I have one... 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I have 6 different trash cans to separate my trash, and they all go out on different days. Oh, it's actually nice because they care about what happens to their trash. It is a little stressful sometimes, but I've gotten used to it. Japan has these trash cans, like, where you separate your trash, even at, like, restaurants. Like, all restaurants have this.
Like, that's cool.
And they even have a drain for your drink, so, like, drinks don't get into the trash bag. It's genius. I don't know why America doesn't have this. And now when I go back to America and I just throw everything in one trash can, I feel like the most wasteful human being in the world. Secondly, 80% of the apartments that you look at when looking for an apartment to rent will not let you live there because you're a foreigner. A lot of the time, even if you speak Japanese, they still won't let you live there. So out of 10 of the apartments that you like, only 2 of them will be available for you. I would send my realtor like a list of 20 apartments and she'd be like, yeah, this one said that you can live here. Thirdly, we do not have dryers in Japan unless you're rich. Even when you're rich, it's like a combination washer dryer and it's really not that good. And also a lot of people's washers are like on the balcony outside. Like mine's out here and I have to hang all my clothes up and put them on this thing as well.
I would hate
and when it's cold outside, it sucks because drying your clothes takes so much longer than in the summer. And also the pipe to your washer can freeze. Children start walking to and from school and also taking the train from the age of 5 and 6. So if you're just out walking around and you see a kid just like walking alone by themselves, they're fine. They're normally just walking to or from school. And fifth, a lot of stuff in Japan is still paper-based, so basically all of my bills I still have to pay, like, at the convenience store. Like, I get it in the mail and I have to take it to the convenience store to pay it, and it has to be in cash. I think some places allow you to, like, switch your bills to online now, but it's all in Japanese and kind of difficult to navigate. And lastly, you see these all the time in Japan. When I first saw this, I was like, what is going on? But schools will take kids in, like, these carts or just on a stroll around the neighborhood. I think I'm gonna do a part 2. Here's what my list hell? Of things in Japan.
I'ma leave you bankrupt, bitch. And you can bank on money.
Battle in the Valley, February 18th.
It's Mercedes. Who's your favorite female wrestler, Sin?
Well, she's kinda dead.
Which one?
China.
Why?
Because I like a woman who can fight a man.
Okay. I heard about that. She paced away. So right now the video was Sasha Banks and Mercedes Monet. I'm guessing Sasha's the one on the floor and Mercedes is the one with the crazy hair. No, Sasha Banks is actually the crazy hair. Mercedes is on the floor. That's crazy.
Yeah, Sasha's the one holding the title.
Yeah, but so which is your favorite now? Alive, not dead.
Well, I'm going to tell you who my least favorite one is.
Okay.
Charlotte Flair.
Who's Charlotte Flair?
Charlotte Flair is Ric Flair's daughter. And the reason I don't like her is because they didn't give her her own legacy. She literally is currently on the fast track to matching her father's title runs and wins. Literally, they are just giving her his legacy before he passes away.
They're just handing it to her, basically?
Yes, she is already a 14 or 15-time women's champion. Her father is a 16 or 18-time world champion.
But he earned it though, right?
I wouldn't say he earned it as much as, well, the thing is, he was a good wrestler. He was very entertaining. I'm not saying he didn't earn it, but I'm saying he wrestled in a time where black people were not really appreciated in wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even to a certain point up into modern day, Vince McMahon has kept the title basically off of people of color in any way, shape, or form.
I'm not using
color as like a direct, you know, black. I'm saying like
anybody
people of color.
Spanish,
like, yes, like it's a
Chinese.
Like as a catch-all. Right. The only exceptions to that has been Eddie Guerrero, because Eddie Guerrero was one of those people that just like,
he caught everybody's heart.
Yeah, he was too much to hold back.
Soap operas are more entertaining. Wrestling seems silly to watch now. Yeah.
The only reason that is because now you know it's basically a grown-up soap opera.
Oh, yeah, definitely. But it's becoming less entertaining.
What a statement! Have tickets sold out yet?
I mean, if anything, it's picked up a little bit since Triple H took over. Creative end.
That's good.
I'm gonna be honest, Triple H still doesn't know how to properly do certain things. I feel like he should give the superstars a bit more leeway and let the rating of the show go up a bit. Even
hey guys,
further from
so
14
I recently
plus
had a
or whatever.
Right. Yeah, Link said that he, which is kind of weird that you guys keep calling him Dark. I mean, I don't think he cares, but I just am used to calling him Link. So when I hear the word Dark, I'm like, I have a few people in the community that have Dark and then something else. So it's a little confusing to me sometimes, but I know you guys are talking about Link. Ellie's over here. Yeah. Yeah. Hey, I mean, that happens. How else can you do the same thing and say it's different to me? I don't care if it's fake. Right. It's like watching a Disney series and then expecting there to be new commentary. Unless they keep up with trends, and then you might have be onto something. It might seem stupid to a lot of people, but it's like, man, this is so stupid, but man, is it catchy. You know what I mean?
Okay. Well, I mean, that's what the song Happy was for me. Yeah, like, I am not a typically, from what I have been told, I am not a typically happy individual, and I particularly don't like naturally happy people, because I'm just like, what fruit of God did you eat when you were born to freaking feel that way?
It's like, fucking screw your day, man. Screw your day, and rue the day you were born, you fucking overly happy piece of shit.
Like, if I had to describe it, like, I was born a Scrooge.
I don't think you're a Scrooge. I think you were dealt a really bad hand.
Let me finish it. Like, I feel like I was born, like, I don't like this, and I don't like you either. Kind of thing.
I'm sorry, hold on. Let me react, goddammit. you just took me out with that. Come on. You can't continue casually when you say stuff like that.
Well, yes, I can, because it feels so natural to say. It's just like, I was born into this, and I don't like it, and I don't like you either, kind of thing.
Stop watching it since AJ Lee quit. I'm so mad. I was this close to catching 7-star Ditto. Aww.
But at the same time, I like entertaining people. And see, what's weird about me is that I don't like people, but I like helping people.
Okay, hold on. I have an easy term for this. Let's see if you can catch on, Sin. Let's see how our brain cells have connected recently, since there's been a huge disconnect between me and you. I don't like people. I like my people. I like my peoples. Meaning you choose who you like and who you don't like. Me personally, if I don't know you or I have no direct connection to you, I don't like you. That does not mean I will not give the shirt off my back, because that is the type of character I have and the type of person that I am. I like helping people. I want everybody to be good. But I'm also conscious of the fact that I can't save you all, and I can't be a miracle worker and make the world happy. So suck my ass. Or don't.
I'm going to be honest, like, you should probably from now on just continue to use the word don't or don't.
Don't or don't. Okay.
Do or don't.
No, yeah, I mean, it's suck my ass or suck my ass. What about that?
I mean, the only reason I say that is because for some people that's an invitation. For other people, that's a fuck off.
Yeah.
There are multiple types of people in the world, and you don't want to attract the ones that you don't want to attract.
Well, I mean, the same thing that happened in Ellie's community will definitely happen in mine, and a ban will happen. So, you know, viewer's discretion is advised. Would you like to see someone eating my ass, or would you like to see someone eating my ass on the way out?
Well...
Morning shenanigans with Luna and Sin.
Whenever we're both tired, because I just woke up and she hasn't slept.
Raymond said, what is going on right now? Just talking.
Cat's eating, apparently.
It's my way of saying you either accept me for what I am and who I am and the way I am as a person, or you could fuck off. Like, I know I'm not for everybody. I have a very specific personality. There is no in-betweens with me, people like me. You either love me or you hate me. Or you either love me and then hate me, or you hate me and then you love me. So, you choose. Just saying.
Listen to this.
Hold on.
And, you know, that's what trips me out. It's like, we say women got the unrealistic expectations, and some of them do. But ain't nobody got...
Hold up. I want everybody in my chat to listen to this video real quickly. I want to see if it makes the point that I was trying to make the other day about when I was playing Pokemon, which I guess it was on Friday. And I said that not all men, I was only speaking about men in my opinion. My opinion, okay? And my experience that I feel like a lot, if not most men, not all men, but most men was the key word, have an unrealistic expectation about how they perceive relationships and why they're not committing. It's when I asked, like, why do men not ask women out on dates, or why do they not commit and actually get into relationships with women like me, for instance. Listen to this video, guys.
Listen to this.
And, you know, that's what trips me out. It's like, we say women got the unrealistic expectations, and some of them do, but ain't nobody got more unicorn, fairy tale, door to explore expectations of the opposite sex than us men. Again, some women do expect a man to be 6 feet tall and make six figures and have a six-pack abs, and that's absolutely unrealistic for most men. But I know, like, 10 dudes already that fit into that category. All you got to do is have a good job and some good genetics, and you're straight. But look at us. Like, what do we expect of a woman? She got to be a virgin, but she got to be a freak. Look, she got to pay half the bills, but she got to do 100% of the cleaning, the cooking, the child raising. She got to be exhausted from all of that. You know, all the cooking and washing and cleaning and all that good stuff, and still be horny enough to meet our sexual needs and get a good night's rest, but also wake up in the middle of the night in case we want some head and a turkey sandwich. That ain't it. She also got to give birth to all our babies, because, you know, we got to have that legacy.
Yep.
But then she can't have no stretch marks, and she got to lose that baby weight in 30 days or less. And then she got to do it while fighting postpartum depression by herself, because we're going to tell her she having an attitude or something like that, because all we thinking about is we ain't got no vagina in the last 6 weeks that she got to take to heal. That ain't it. Then she can get older, but she can't look older. Otherwise, we're going to say that she's falling off. Like, the list goes on, but just tell me something. How many women do you know that fit into that category?
None.
So who really got the unrealistic expectations?
Men.
Listen to this.
Sorry.
And, you know, that's what trips me out.
Were you listening to that?
I could barely hear it because I had to turn down the... I basically turned the stream volume off so I would quit repeating to myself.
You could mute the Discord real quick if you want, and I'll replay it for you.
Okay, give me a
just second. Let me know. I I felt so misunderstood Friday, and again, no hard feelings, but I felt so misunderstood, and I couldn't find the right words, and I just really, really want someone who has at least a closer connection to me, or somebody who just understands what I was trying to say. I might have said the wrong words, and so this is coming. Hold on, before I press play again, so that you can hear it, let me know again when you're ready, but this is... All the information that I was getting from based off of Friday came from a man. None of the videos that I will pull up will ever be in the perception or the perspective of a female. Because you as a man, right, just be real with me. If I was to tell you that I heard a video of a woman saying XYZ about how men have an unrealistic expectation, not all, just they're a large group, I would... literally be like ripped to shreds. Oh, well, that's feminism at its finest and blah 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 blah. And women, of course a woman would say that. How would you know? I was getting information from the mouth of men saying that they are admitting that they are selfish and that they are sometimes pieces of shit and are manipulative and all of these negatives. And I get that. But
see, I would like to go ahead and add something here, and this is where
go ahead.
I feel like I constantly have a disagreement with you on that.
No, no, no. I'm not stating that these are my words. I am repeating.
I understand. But, that's not what I'm saying. Right, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying you're taking the words of multiple certain individuals that are male representative because they have a penis.
Oh, no,
present as male. I hate to say it, but I don't view things like that. I view every person as their own individual.
So
fuck
do I.
Their female
so do I.
Group.
I am like I can only base off of my experiences, not and I use keywords, not all. I'm fully woke on that. I know a lot of women that they got their hearts broken, they've gotten cheated on, you name the whole nine yards, and they hate men. And what did I tell you, Ellie? Because I'm not trying to call you out in a negative aspect, but what did I tell you? Every single time you came to me before sin was in your life, before you guys got back together, what did I tell you? Don't give up on men, because if you go both ways, that's just double the opportunities that you can have with people. Just because you lean more towards women doesn't mean shit. I called Ellie out. I feel like I had a direct hand in you rekindling with her, personally. Did I do all the work? No. I was the voice of reason for both of you. If not just her. I feel like I played a part with you, Sin. Again, you can correct me if I'm wrong. Did I do all the work? No. You guys did that on your own. But if I would have not said anything, would you guys be where you're at? Probably not.
Probably not, because she would have... and this is just my perspective, Ellie. I think she would have just been like, no, there's no way. Even if I had gone back to her and been like, Ellie, if you just do this, this, and this...
Right.
She would have probably not listened to me because of her hurt feelings that I gave her.
But I think her hurt feelings were her defense mechanism for her hurting you. You had every right to feel the way that you did. And again, I don't want to make this about you guys. I'm glad you guys are good and you're happy and it's better than ever. Sometimes it takes that. Sometimes it takes, like with me and my situation, maybe better will come out of it. And
it takes a house blowing to rebuild a better foundation.
Yeah. And in my situation currently, without saying too much, I'm not trying to give up. I'm not trying to walk away. I know how I feel. I know they're not going to go away overnight. I know it's not going to happen like that. You can keep your distance from me, and it doesn't fucking matter. I know what I feel. I know the connection that I have with a person, and it doesn't just go away. And it's exhausting, and it's been very straining on my mental health, and hopefully... Between the last few weeks, you guys have seen a difference. Again, I'm not really getting feedback, so I don't know. But, you know, I ended my year on a really bad note. I will talk to you in private about this, because this is actually something I do need to get off my chest with you and Ellie, but on my own terms. It's easier to talk to you because I don't think Ellie will jump into a call where she can hear me in private. But I think it's about that time. I've been quiet for too long, and if I don't step in and say something, then it's only going to get worse, and it might ruin our friendships. So I'd rather
and
not.
Is that what the indicator was in that one thing on here?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I had something to say in response to that, but right after that, you were having such a good time in stream. I was just like, you know what? It doesn't fucking matter what I have to say about it, but eh.
I chose to end the conversation the way I did so that there wasn't arguments or hard feelings, and I might have said things rushingly, but...
You were in the middle of a live. I already knew that's not fully what you were trying to say anyway.
Absolutely.
It was just, like, maybe the bits of the core.
You did kind of help, because I was going to give up and go full, oh my lordy. But that's the thing, though. I have a wide perception, so I was able to look and analyze Sin, for instance, Ellie. If we're gonna have this TED talk, as long as you guys are both giving me the green light.
You know me, I'm full open. I really don't care one way or another. It's not, in my opinion, it's not going to matter in the end, because I still have feelings for her. She still has feelings for me.
Then I knew,
and it's
I knew
not going to change it.
Well, no, I'm not trying to change anything. It's a respect.
No, I'm not saying you are. I'm just saying overall, it being aired out in public is not going to change how I feel.
It could, but I'm not like that. But no, it's just... You guys are in a good place, and if it's working for you, then it's working for you. But I'm just stating that I know my hand in both your both. There's three sides to it, and I had a hand in three different ports, if that makes sense. Yours individually, hers individually, and you guys as a unit. And if I wouldn't have said anything, I do not think that you guys would be where you're at. But I knew how both of you guys felt, and I knew in that instance that the both of you needed interjection. It's almost like when you're getting an intervention for being an addict for some reason, like drugs or alcohol. Hey, I need to talk to you. I love you, but you're being a dickhead. Hey, I love you, Ellie, but you're being kind of a bitch. You guys need to stop this shit. And so that's more of a joke, but I kind of said those in my own way, both ends. And I was just like, you're talking about it still, so you still have feelings for it, you know? You don't – usually when you don't care about something, you don't talk about it. Or when you're over something, you don't bring it up as much. You can still bring it up. It affected you, you know? So.
I just read what Ellie wrote.
Good Lord. You're not a bitch. If you were a bitch, the situation that you brought she brought to my attention what happened, and I got a little upset. I'm not going to lie. I called it. I knew it was going to happen eventually. I was monitoring chat. When I wasn't on this, when I was playing games, I was able to peek in every single time that she was live. But I wasn't able to monitor today or like this duration of stream. So when she went live,
I almost went off on someone today. But we're going to leave that.
If you want to talk, if you want to say names, I'm just respecting boundaries. I'm not trying to cross anything. I'm not like that. I'm not a gossiper. I'm not trying to talk shit. I don't know what happened. If you want to tell me about it, that's cool. If you don't, that's cool.
I'm not going to tell. I'm not going to tell it because that's Ellie's to tell if she wants to.
She brought it to my attention. She brought it to my attention. All right, Ellie.
I know, but I'm saying like in the public realm that is up to her.
Right. She kind of brought it in chat and kind of said it in DMs, if I'm not mistaken. Didn't you bring it up in chat, Ellie? No, that idiot attacked me in... Yeah, so now she's bringing it publicly. So I already know how Ellie is. Ellie don't give a fuck either.
We are very much suited to each other in that fashion.
Right, but I'm the same way, which you know that, Sin. I filter myself for streams. Because if I don't have, I already have a bad reputation enough as it is. Whether you want to argue with me on that and be like, no, you're good, bestie. And then Ellie will be like, no, sis, you're fine. No, I'm actually not. I'm not. I have a bad rep on me right now. Whether you see it that way or not, the way I'm being treated says a lot. But I have good news. I do have good news, and I'll share it to you in private. So maybe you already know the good news, and maybe you don't.
I have a feeling I know where it might lean towards, but I don't know what it would be about.
DM me real quick. Idiot attacked me in mail, so none of you could see. Yep, that's fine if you want to put it in there. Just not in a public chat. But that's the thing, though, Ellie. I have a question. When I wrote in chat, no. Nothing about that.
Okay, I figured it might be that, but I was like, that's probably not exactly what it is.
Oh, no. The other one. Let's see if you can figure it out. The other issue. Not that.
I'm going to ask. This one?
Hold on. No.
Because there's a lot of little webs in this.
Go ahead, keep going. Let's see if you can figure it out.
Okay, hot or cold on the last one? Like, is it within the realm?
I mean, it's part
of... Is it friendship-based?
Yeah. But not who you're... Like, not your third guess. I already know who you're going to say, and it's not her.
No, I wasn't going to say her. Because I already know that's fine. But it is friendship-based. The way you're saying yeah makes me think there's more to it.
Yeah. Keep going. I'm waiting for the note on my phone.
So I'm pretty sure if it's friendship based, but it's also a bit more, then it's probably this one.
Waldo's just, he's like, I don't know what's
actually going on. This is going to be a combo guess.
$5 for Luna found new honey. What do you mean I found a new honey? Nah, I'm not like that. No, definitely not.
Nah. Okay. That's my last guess then, because now I'm sure I'm way off. So. Oh. Okay. Well, you threw me off when you said it was a freaking, like you implied there was more to it, and I'm like, no, that would be friendship.
It's not romantic, okay?
Look. Well, to me, this is where I fall apart on that, is
nobody's
like
romantic with me at the moment.
Well, see, that's where I fall apart on this, is just like there's only two stages to people being close to me, and other than, because I just auto include family, so that's not even a thought,
right?
You know,
no, right. I get
so it automatically goes to, are they in a wanting a relationship with me, or are they wanting a friendship with me? And those are the only two ways you get close to me.
Well,
if you're not family ready.
In the words of Tech, you know, from that one stream, if you know, you know, where apparently a bunch of people, this one person came into my chat and they said that they would 1v1 to date me, which fucking stupid. You.
Yeah, that's really dumb.
Yeah, and he says it doesn't matter if you win, she's still coming home with me, which I thought was one of, and again, I'm not even just trying to fangirl over it, one of the most attractive things that person has said. Because I was just like,
you see, I've said that before, and immediately the person I was talking about went with the other guy, even though we had been talking. I'm like, oh, so you all have been talking.
Wait, what do you mean? Oh.
I had a situation in which I was apparently the other guy back in my life, didn't know I was the other guy. I thought I was the main guy.
Ah, when you think you're the main, when you think you're the main character, but you're actually the side one.
Yeah, and I'm just over here like, wow, I didn't realize main characters, you know, did that sort of thing we did with non-main characters. Okay.
One thing I did learn, though, in life is sometimes you're not the main character in other people's
lives. No, it is not the person that starts with a T. That was my first guess.
Huh? You could say, wait, you could, don't censor him or his identity. Who are you talking about?
You Tito? Already know, but Tito? He needs to.
No, Tito, we talking about Tony? What's your name?
We talking about Tosquitos?
Yeah, we talking about Tommy? Like, who are we talking about? You trying to dead name him already? God damn. Nah. I mean, I say his name. I'm not dead naming him. That's fucked up. That's disrespectful as fuck.
See, I don't even see it as what Waldo is doing as dead naming. He's not intentionally doing it. It's just that he thinks that it's going to be an issue, and it really shouldn't be.
Right. But, like, I guess, you know, the lack of
because presence. Here's the thing. I'll say it. I'll say it out loud on stream. Tech. Hi, Tech. Hello, Tech.
Hi, Tech.
That's
tech.
That's just the thing. It's not that he is an issue. It's that an issue involving him happened.
Right. And I want that situation. Personally, if I could have it my way, I'm just going to share my feelings. I'm not trying to step on anybody's toes. I think he's earned his way back. Not earned his way back in. I think that at the very least, I would want the unban and let him figure it out for himself.
I think I'm going to go with this. If he continues to say that he is going to do whatever he wants to do, it does not try to control it, I don't think he deserves to be back yet.
No, I know, but
stance as a mod.
No, I agree. I think that.
Now, I would like to throw out my stance as a person.
Right.
Which I believe
that's important, by the way.
I believe that anyone who fucks up and does not leave a body behind deserves a second chance.
Mm-hmm. I do too. I just didn't know.
As fucked up as it may
have been. You can say his name, Waldo. Like, there is only one person's name in my chat that is forever banned. There's only one. And Tech's not one of them. And I will fight a mod.
Technically, there's two. No. Technically, there's two. Yes, there is. There's the one with the D, there's the one with the that starts with a D, and then there's the one that starts with
a
D.
That's a me thing because I well, okay, yeah. Yeah,
yes, but it's your stream, so it's a stream thing.
Okay, so there's two, and he's not one of them, and nor do they have his letter. So the reason why is one of them is my ex-best friend, and it's because if a person allows, and this goes to anybody in the community, let this be a lesson out of my mouth. If any one of you sees I am being unjustly treated, even by Sin, by Koa, by JP, it doesn't matter, I don't give a fuck who it is. If you allow and you sit back for people to bully me, grown adults bully me, you're not my friend. And you also don't belong in my community. I don't do that to you guys. I would never allow, like, Sin to bully K or anything. Like, play around, cool. Do your thing. Pop off. Pop your pussy for a real one. I don't care. That's none of my business. But if she generally comes into my DMs or calls me and she's belligerently crying or something, like, yo, this shit happened, like, no.
Right. I'm going to go ahead and put my, like, I established that if it doesn't leave a body behind.
Yeah.
My personal thing is, if you physically harm someone, you're dead to me.
Yeah.
If it's someone that didn't fucking deserve it, if they did not fucking deserve it, you're dead to me.
I totally deserve to get my ass slapped, just saying.
I held my tongue due to the fact that I do not want to say what I normally would have said because my girlfriend is here.
I'm sure she'd be okay with it. It's just a jokey joke.
Yeah.
No, that wasn't very convincing.
Yeah. Okay, say it. Okay, so,
Ooh, she says, ooh, what you say?
So what I would have normally said is, you know, I've done forgot what I would normally say. It's been so long.
It's always a button.
Well, you already just said you wanted your ass slapped. I was going to be like, yeah, and then, you know, take him for a ride, pampered.
Take notes, guys.
Maybe 6 more times of riding.
I don't know about all that. That sounds like a lot of work. In the name of Daisy, that's a lot of work.
I wasn't saying you would be doing the riding.
I don't have a dick to ride on.
He's got to do some driving. He can't just let you do the riding.
Listen, I love a good plow. Just saying. Maybe a little good drill. Good thrusting, you know. Maybe 6 more times of riding. That's a lot. Yeah, see, look, she came on. Yo, good morning. Good morning, Daisy. She came out of fucking left field for that. I told you, it was bound to happen. I was waiting.
Sin says sexual comment. Daisy is not far behind.
No, see, I set it up. Just remember that.
I have a feeling you saw her name pop into chat, and you're like, yeah, Daisy.
Hi. Good morning.
Maybe.
Maybe a little bit of spinning, like, you know, you're on the dance floor.
You spin my head right round when you go down, when you go down.
You know what's really funny? I turned that, like, I made a literal VOD to that song, a literal VOD, and then I made a not literal VOD where I was playing, like, you know, there's that game where you can actually twist people's head around as you're, you know, when you kill them.
Oh, God.
So every single time that it said, you spin my head right round, it was just someone's head getting snapped around.
Oh, I love that.
It made me laugh. I was just like, it's just like, you spin my head right round.
And you hear the crunching noises, it's the best.
Yes, and then when for the go down part is just her body falling limp, and I'm just like, this is morbidly hilarious.
Pretty much. Aw, I didn't get a hug. Where's my morning hug, you whore? Something inside of me just told me to wake up and not miss something. I channeled you, that's why.
Sid is talking. Things are about to go down.
No,
I will not miss
her. I physically channeled her. I'm not even going to hold off on that.
Yeah, you messaged her?
No, I spiritually channeled her. She literally just said it out loud. She goes, something told me.
Just in her brain.
Did you not notice I got quiet for a second?
Oh no, I was just saying, in her brain, she just heard a silent voice screaming in her head, arise.
No.
And she did.
It's just my voice in her head. Bitch, wake up. Bitch, what the fuck? I don't know, Daisy, what did you hear in your head that woke you up?
Unsettled screaming noises.
Was it, goat howls?
I'm gonna be honest because, every single time.
All I want is you to be as honest.
I know, but it's just, it's a phrase I say, and I'm starting to think, like, it just, it's really annoying. I can be, I will say it again.
I don't think you're annoying.
It's really annoying that I straight up say I'm gonna be honest, because literally whatever comes out of my mouth is, like, pure grade, like, beef. Here it is.
Yeah. You said beef.
IDK, you don't hear anything. You just know you're doing it right. What?
You talking about me? I don't. Again, remember what I was talking about earlier, Daisy? Where I said.
Do you mean you don't hear anything? Like you personally? Or are you saying she doesn't hear anything? Because I wouldn't think she would hear anything because she's the one sending the message.
No, it's a signal. I don't know how else
like
to describe.
Like when you give head, what?
No, okay. Like, have you ever been alone in a room and you felt like that random tinge or twitch where you know something's touching you, but you can't explain it because there's nothing there. It's like that. You can blame tech for that because I have somehow subconsciously perfected that. When you send like a million dreams and not all of them are PG-13 to help distract and do stuff and things I'm not talking about on stream. I don't know. I go into this place in my head. It's like a brain telephone. I think that's the weirdest way to describe it.
Apparently, Waldo is closing his eyes for some reason.
What do you mean? I do close my eyes sometimes. I don't know. It's
Waldo
just,
said he's closing his eyes. I don't know.
Why are you closing your eyes, Waldo?
Because it was so funny. He's dead now. He closed his eyes.
Perhaps do you need a resuscitation?
You know, I personally feel like we should make a special command for Daisy for when she disappears for a little while.
We do.
Oh, is it revived? Because that's what I was thinking it should be.
RIP you, Waldo. You will be missed. Waldo, he was a real one.
We doing pets. Who you petting?
She's probably petting you.
Nah, it's probably you, because she's in your chat.
So? Just because she's in my chat don't mean that she's petting me.
Everybody get a head pat.
No. Because if everybody's getting a head pat, I'm going to get jealous and I don't want it.
Well, you should be jealous. I get belly rubs.
I don't want a belly rub. That just makes me feel fat. I want a booty rub.
It makes me feel like Buddha. I'm all important. People rub my belly.
No. I want a guy to be like mesmerized by my little booty and just to slap it and just say, it move like water. That's what I want them to do.
Chad is getting head pats. I was right the second guess I got.
Nope. It wasn't your first one.
I need to get on with my research. Okay. And for that, I need a lovely lady. Spider. No fruits, no vegetables, but a lady!
Yeah, for a little bit. For a little bit.
I'm probably going to get up out of bed here at 9:30 and take a shower.
That gives me a good excuse to hold you off from that temporarily so that I could say what I need to say after and then let you go. Because I'll do my walk. That gives me an excuse.
The only reason I want to take a shower is because I didn't get one last night.
Yeah, I slept a good hour last night. You missed it. Yeah, I fell asleep on stream and I was talking in my sleep. Yeah, it was great. Sim was there for it. He held the conversation and everything. Stream never was better. We got rated by like 10,000 people. It was phenomenal. Like you just miss all the good stuff. It's really sad.
There were champagne corks flying through the sky.
Yeah, I turned my camera on off my phone. I don't know how that happened. And y'all all saw me sleeping. No cameras were involved. You know, like, nobody took screenshots because, you know, they actually respected me and my boundaries. But if you were there, you know. No, I haven't slept. I've been here the whole time. Bitch, don't lie. You definitely fell asleep. Log in. You a whole lie.
Yeah, she fell asleep right next to you.
No, she fell asleep in my lap, and I woke her up. And I'm not going to tell you.
So that's what you mean by you sent a mental message.
No. I don't know how, like, honestly.
I was just saying, Sonny, I get it. It's like you're thinking about someone and then they hear you.
No, because if that was the case, there have been moments where I wanted to reach out to you and it didn't get to you.
That's because I'm not as spiritually aware as most people. I do see ghosts.
Neither is Daisy.
Yes, but Daisy has more of a connection to you than I do because she's on a deeper level.
No, you have a just as deep of, you have your own little connection. It's
yes, but hers is on a deeper level because she's the one you normally reach out to.
I don't reach
out
to her.
Or she reaches out to you.
I don't reach out to her. Y'all both about to sleep your whole day off.
Isn't that what a day off is for?
Yeah, that's what we do. Means see, I'm glad. See, look, that's why we're best friends right there. You see, you get it. You get it.
Like, I'm not allowed to sleep because I have work things to do on these other days. Can I sleep the day I have off?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, bye.
Exactly. I actually slept,
Don't even make that a joke.
Waldo, don't lie. That's a timeout if I ever saw one.
That's a joke too far.
That's a 2-second timeout if I ever saw one. Just saying. You know, if I had a mod in chat, just saying.
But if sure. I quit hitting, if I would quit hitting the kappas, it'd already be gone.
Well, this is probably like, oh shit, Luna's being mean. That was a joke that was taken serious.
It was just 2 seconds.
I know.
Or does it do it in minutes or does it do it in seconds?
No, it's okay. 2 seconds. No, but it was funny because that was a joke. And Waldo, see, look, you understood the assignment, Waldo. That was a joke that was taken serious that it's a joke. That is great.
I am just so glad they made it where timing someone out or, like, they used to have it where timing someone out would take their VIP away. And I'm just like, this is just extra steps. No, Waldo, you're not getting timed out.
Right. Just think about all the times you guys couldn't have timed Spider out, but now you can. I thought somebody timed him out because my bot decided to talk instead.
It takes 90 payments of whatever.
What are you talking about?
To time out Spider. It takes 90 payments of blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, no, it don't work like that. That's a lot of work to click someone's name. He's like, hold up, what? I was making a joke. I said, to think that back in the day, it took your VIP away and it took your mod badge away. So it was a lot more work earlier in before I streamed. This was long before I streamed. And now it just takes the mod badge out.
I'm just going to go ahead and say that Daisy, you doing those little bitty sentences to me is a lot more work than typing a whole sentence because I have to hit the enter button too many times.
Yep. But yeah, back on track for a minute, Sin. I want you to listen to this video.
Okay, I gotta
deafen yourself. Yep, just let me know.
I gotta remove myself from spiritual existence.
And then come back.
Yeah.
Just let me know.
After I figure out how the fuck I get into Discord again. Okay. Oof. I'm phone. Phone.
These nuts.
There it is.
Got him! Got him!
Just type in chat when you're ready. Caracosta? I don't know what that Pokemon is. Link, you still here? You just say you don't want to time me out. No, that's not what she's saying at all. She's adding to my joke, Spider. Now? Okay.
Listen to this.
Just listen.
You know, that's what trips me out. It's like, we say women got the unrealistic expectations, and some of them do, but ain't nobody got more unicorn, fairy tale, door to explore expectations of the opposite sex than us men. Again, some women do expect a man to be 6 feet tall and make six figures and have a six-pack abs, and that's unrealistic for most men. But I know, right, like 10 dudes already that fit into that category. All you got to do is have a good job and some good genetics, and you're straight. But look at us. Like, what do we expect of a woman? She got to be a virgin, but she got to be a freak. She got to pay half the bills, but she got to do 100% of the cleaning, the cooking, the child raising. She got to be exhausted from all of that, you know, all the cooking and washing and cleaning and all that good stuff, and still be horny enough to meet our sexual needs and get a good night's rest, but also wake up in the middle of the night in case we want some head and a turkey sandwich. That ain't it. She also got to give birth to all our babies because, you know, we got to have that legacy. But then she can't have no stretch marks, and she got to lose that baby weight in 30 days or less. And then she got to do it while fighting postpartum depression by herself, because we're going to tell her she having an attitude or something like that, because all we thinking about is we ain't got no vagina in the last 6 weeks that she got to take to heal. That ain't it. Then she can get older, but she can't look older. Otherwise, we're going to say that she's falling off. Like, the list goes on, but just tell me something. How many women do you know that fit into that category? None. So who really got the unrealistic expectations?
Listen to this.
I'll wait.
And you know, that's what
I'll wait. Head in a turkey sandwich. But like, he was just dumbing it down, if you didn't realize that. I was trying to put some thought into it. I was trying to put more information into it when I was talking about this on Friday. And again, I'm not talking about all men are like that. I'm not talking about that.
Yeah, because I'm gonna go ahead and straight up say, because I disagreed with every single one of those things, because everything he said that
he categorized
most men,
wait, when he, but that's the thing.
I know, listen, Linda. Yes, but you're going. Hold on, okay, Linda, said, listen to me.
But you're not letting me finish my sentence. I have sat here and I've let you say whatever you needed to say, because I'm trying to give you your voice. But I use key words, and if you are taking it personal onto yourself, then that is a you problem, because I know who I'm excluding. I know who doesn't treat me like this. I know who would cater and kiss the feet I walk, you know, that I, the floor I walk on. As even as a friend, I know you don't fit into this category, but you can see where I'm coming from.
As a friend, you should also know the same thing that literally ticks you off with what this guy is saying.
He pisses me off.
I know, but at the same time, it pisses me off both ways, because people are fucking morons.
Oh, no, I 1,000% agree. That's why
that's my point.
It confuses me when you say you disagree, but we're saying the same thing. You're saying that, like, it's dumb and why it shouldn't be like that. And I'm glad you're not in that statistic. I'm glad you're not in that box where I don't have to check it off with you, because
let me go down the line. The reason I am okay with a woman having stretch marks after having my child is because those stretch marks are from her having my child. That is the ultimate love right there.
But what if she has stretch marks and it's not from having your child? I know men
It doesn't fucking matter, because now she's mine and that other guy can fuck off.
Right, but that doesn't have to be from another man. One thing that Tech has said to me, if I remember correctly, it may not be word for word, he argued with me over me being insecure for other people putting me down for it. Not all, but it's just the reason that I was upset with it, or I wanted them removed surgically, because you can do that, is because they hurt. Where I was talking about is towards my, not my groin, but it's like the bikini line. It's like right where my leg and the torso part, like if my legs were cut
off.
Yeah,
but that's a personal thing.
Right.
That's not a.
But I realized where his head was at. If like me and him were dating, for instance, right? And if I was to put myself down in front of him, he would argue with me. Don't talk about my girl like that. Like, he has my energy when it comes to that. So I appreciated that, even though he may have been misunderstanding, like, for reasons that I'm not going to voice out. But he may have misunderstood what I was trying to get at. But I appreciated that nonetheless, because it was just like, oh, so he can appreciate a woman's body for what it is and understands that. And I understand he doesn't have that high expectation where I'm supposed to be this type of weight and look this type of way, you know. So I fucked with it. So Stretch marks or not. I would love her the same. Stretch marks or not. And I appreciate them like this.
For this wet ass. Toilet paper won't do shit for my wet ass. You'll need a lifeguard and a floaty for my wet ass.
That's how she speaks. Try and understand the message, I think. People will always be more. Absolutely. No, I think Sin knows what I'm trying to say. I just have to. Sometimes I have to fight him for him.
It's not that I don't understand it. It's that the initial saying of it pisses me off because I know it's a general catch-all most of the time.
Right.
But it pisses me off that people think like that. I'm just over here like.
I don't think that even the person, it's not even the initial person from the video. That was his.
Have a good one at work, Spider.
Have a good day at work. He was putting it
from
me.
I just wanted to catch him real quick.
He was doing it from his perspective. And I think that because, you know, TikTok, you only have so much time. So he kind of just grouped it and he condensed it. That's the word I was looking for. He condensed it, shortened it. He did a short edit instead of it being, like, drawn out and it being an actual discussion where, like, what we're doing a podcast-style thing where we're able to talk about a topic and we're able to correlate what we want to say or put in our thought process, whereas in these types of videos, it's shorter. So you get the general idea of what he's trying to say. That's all I wanted you to hear. I didn't really care for the...
I get the general idea, but it immediately pissed me off with each little tagline he said that a man expects. Because literally, that is what a man in the 40s expected of a woman.
Unfortunately, I'm going to interject that a lot of more men than you probably are, you know, exposed to, and maybe Spider can briefly or even Link, because Link is in Florida. Like, I can only speak about my vicinity or like the men that have been around me, whether they're in Florida or they're in another state or another country. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but it's still very much to this day that's how.
Yeah, but I'm gonna go ahead and say I noticed that the places that is mostly intact are very low southern states and very up high northern states.
Maybe.
Like, the more extremes that you get to each side of the upper and lower,
right,
they seem to be more extreme in that category. And I don't understand why. I'm starting to think it's the thin air or the salt in the water on the air or something. Because right. People, like, I don't understand. Like, I'm over here like, why are you all being idiots and not just taking a chance? And yeah, if she fucks someone else and you're not into that, then yeah, sorry, you chose bad and you suck.
Right, right. But basically what it was stating was what I was trying to say on Friday. And I felt like my message kind of got lost in transit and I got really upset and I just deaded the topic because I wasn't trying to upset people that were clear. They're going to say they weren't upset, but you know, some people may have not understood where I was coming from, and that's totally fine. But basically, it was just my standpoint of my experiences, my opinion. I'm using my words, you know, because it was all about how I felt about things. Did that mean that I thought that you or all the males in my community are like that? No. But I have been exposed to guys that didn't really care about my end of things. They kind of just, it was about them.
I'm going to run Raymond.
Luna, love you. See you tomorrow and take it super duper easy today. Of course. I'll see you on Monday, Raymond. Have a good rest of your day. I'll see you guys on Monday.
Yeah, I wasn't trying to interject. I just wanted to be sure that people that are leaving get said bye to.
Oh, no, absolutely. Before the no, we'll talk about more in depth, but I don't really care. Like, it's not, my cash flow is not being ruined because of it.
But to go back on topic just for half a second.
Yeah, I was trying to go back.
Literally the whole entire reason I get upset is because I'm upset about the topic in general, and it's not even a taking it personal thing most of the time.
I'm
tired of these other guys that have nothing to fucking do with me setting a precedent. And then making it where I can't do shit. Like, say a guy made a bologna sandwich after he beat his girlfriend. I make a bologna sandwich after we make love, and she's triggered by that.
Well, no, absolutely. And so that actually brings up a very, very serious topic for me. That's why it takes me longer to be intimate with guys, and that's why, you know what I'm about to say. When it comes to, like, the sexual stuff,
yeah.
Oftentimes more than not, and I hate that it's like this for me, and I feel really bad for any dude that I get involved with. And obviously in this situation, the last person was, you guys already know who he is, with any emotional and or sexual, it doesn't matter. But it's just, like, I would like to keep parts of my relationship private, if that makes sense. But I have thoughts, and I can't control them, and they go through my head, and because of things that are relatively recent, within the last 5 years, that's still very recent. All guys have made me feel like is I'm good to fuck, but I'm not good to commit to. You know, I'm good enough to flirt with, but I'm not good enough to be in a relationship with. So it's just like, it does set a mindset, and it does set a pretense where it's just like, you start to believe you're not good enough. And I know I am. Like, I don't give a fuck. I know I'm worth it. And I've been, like, verbally saying it out loud. And I hopefully you guys, one or two of you in the chat at the very most, have heard me say it, whether I'm saying it to you in private, whether I'm saying it to you on stream. I say it all the time. I'm worth the smoke. I'm worth the fucking stress. I'm worth the shits and giggles. I don't give a fuck what nobody has to say. I know who I am as a person. I know I'm struggling right now when it comes to finances. But does that mean that I'm always going to be struggling? Maybe not. But we'll never know if you're treating me like shit.
I just want to ask, Gally, what are you surprised about?
Yeah, what you surprised about?
Was it what I said? Because what I was saying was, in a previous relationship, say that the guy used to beat the crap out of his girlfriend, and then he would go make a bologna sandwich.
But see, that's the thing, though. If he was doing it wrong, he would ask her to make him a bologna sandwich.
Well, what I'm getting at is, like, but then I would just make love to her, and then I go make a bologna sandwich. She asks what I'm eating, and I'm eating a bologna sandwich, and she loses her shit on me.
Right. So, unfortunately, like, I think it was a Madea clip, and I know that I'm not trying to, like, make it about a silly thing. It's very serious. When you're dealing with a damaged woman, you have to be patient with her, and you have to be ready for it. You're going to have the bad days, and you're going to have really shitty days and terrible days. But guess what? You want to know what I learned? not like full front at the moment. I hope I can learn this, but just, like, I don't know how to explain it, but it's like I can learn through other people's bad misfortunes and all this stuff, but it's different and it hits different. And I think Koa said it very perfectly, where sometimes there are situations where I can be spoken to and I understand it off rip, or I have to be drilled into, not sexually. Before anybody makes what, don't make the comment.
What do you mean, let them go, Waldo?
Maybe, like, let them go, like they're not worth keeping because they're hurting you. Play the Madea clip. I like them all. If I find it, I think it was on Instagram. It was a while back, like maybe a week ago or something like that. But, you know, it basically, it just, the short end of it was basically saying that, you know, they're just as worth fighting for as a normal person who has it all together and is not a broken person. But the hardest relationship after a toxic one is always going to be the healthy one. It's easy for you to date somebody that was toxic and then you leave them. You finally gather up the courage but the thing is that you have to do the work. When you're in a toxic standpoint or a situation or an environment, especially, it doesn't even have to be relationships like dating. It can be family, can be toxic.
Then I would like to go ahead and add into this.
Go ahead.
Because this is my point of view from that. If you are still reeling from that toxic relationship, you got to deal with that issue.
Hold on. Like, I'm getting to that.
No, I'm saying before you start dating the next person.
Not necessarily, like, but I'm going to give you my standpoint. My point of view. Maybe you just think about it. Don't respond. Just let it marinate.
I'm going to try.
I'm asking you. I'll go into more detail in private because this is not something I want to talk about in full detail on stream, but I'm just like, just hear me out. So
I know, but I'm telling you, I'm going to try because whenever I hear something that pisses me off, I kind of auto respond. So I'm going to do my best.
Your actual mouth with your hand, I just don't want to.
Actually, let me just go ahead and mute myself because I know I will pop off.
Right. Well, no. This has nothing to do with you. Like, you weren't here for this, unfortunately. So
I know, but I know I will pop off as soon as I hear it, so give me a moment. I'm going to mute me.
You don't know what I'm not really going to say a lot of details, so.
It doesn't matter. I will get pissed off. And it's not at you. It will be at the whole entire situation and the fact I wasn't there to punch someone in the dick. So.
Well, I would have liked to punch them in the dick, but I was talking about this earlier. And basically, my last real relationship was like 6 years ago. And I have not successfully gotten into a full-fledged relationship since then. And it was, in my opinion, the worst place I was in mentally. And actually, I have not spoken about this person on stream. Because all you guys are hearing about is another ex. You're not hearing about the one that did the damage. I spent 3 years after that relationship numb. I felt nothing. And you guys can argue with me till you're black and blue. You don't know what I went through. You don't know what it feels like to be a human robot where you're like very aware of the pain you can inflict on another person and you want to. And having to somehow higher power of some sort just smack the ever living fuck out of me. And I stayed alone. And I actually went through an isolation period or hermit mode, as some people in the spiritual realm would say. I stayed the fuck away from people, and I didn't water my friendships, and I wasn't watering my relationships with like my mom and my siblings. It was a gray area in my life where I was very lost and I was very hurt. And when I tried to get into, I guess when I tried to try to be in a relationship, it just so happened to be with somebody who was a piece of shit. I stayed single for probably another year or so after already having a year of my life wasted. And then my saga began in 2020. And just never went anywhere. And I don't really need to go into detail because you already know about that sin. And then now my situation right now. And out of every situation that I encountered, the last one was the most intense. And I feel like if it's to go anywhere, it might be that healthy relationship that both of the people need to kind of work through things. But it's one of those situations, and you may disagree with me, and that is entirely fine, Sin. I'm kind of glad you're muted at this point. But I can't do it alone, and I'm very aware of that. So I would need him to kind of help guide me, as I would help guide him. And that is where the healthy part comes in, where you lack, I have that tool, and you need it, here you go. And you have tools that I need because I'm lacking in that department, and you can help me. That is also something friendships can give to you. Like, genuine friendships where you actually give a fuck about a person, which is why I say Daisy is one of the people. Well, I'm still here because of her. She's one of the main reasons. I'm being dead honest. That is why we're connected the way we are. It was meant to be. You can unmute, by the way. I'm off that, but I know me and Daisy's friendship is weird to a lot of people. Like, how are you acting as if y'all are soulmates and you guys have known each other for 50 years? Don't ask me. Fucking talk to my soul, bro. Talk to her soul, too.
I'm going to tell you right now, it probably has nothing to do with, like, it could be a soulmates thing, I don't know, but there's just some people you fucking click with.
No, she's definitely my soulmate. I'm very vocal about that, and nobody can convince me otherwise, and she agrees.
Daisy or Daisy or you needs to become a dude. That's
no, it's
where
it's,
we're at.
It's not romantic at all. It's platonic as fuck.
I know, but I'm just saying.
Even if she was a dude.
I'm just saying, like, with how you two click, it would probably be like a little. You know what, Daisy? You just need to become her match. There we go.
She's my match.
It would be the healthiest relationship I've ever seen you in.
You haven't seen me in relationships.
I've seen you starting relationships and being a go-getter about them, and then everybody else fucking failing you.
That kind of breaks my heart.
Yeah, it breaks mine too. And that's why I get so pissed off whenever you start getting excited about another guy. And I'm just like, this fucker better not fuck it up or else I'm going to fuck his legs in half.
Well, go fuck his legs. Go ahead.
Fucking cut him off and make him that Christmas lamp from the Christmas Story movie.
Whoa, that got dark really quick. Ellie said, ew.
She probably just heard fuck his legs.
Go ahead. Go do what the family dog does and go hump that leg. Go on. I heard you like that shit. You like
that? I mean, I've been thinking about horrible things for the person that's messing with her, to be honest. A lot of bad shit going through my head as far as that.
Kinky.
You know the old saying. You know the old saying. Sometimes someone just needs to get fucked to get the point.
I don't know about all that.
I don't know. I wouldn't touch him with a 10,000-foot pole.
Have you seen what he looks like?
Don't need to. His soul's dirty.
Yeah. I got that vibe. But, I mean, when I saw him in the chat, was it yesterday? Like, Friday? He didn't seem too bad. It seemed like the conversation
was full fake. He's full fake. I don't care what anyone says. I can sense it a mile fucking away. Full fake. Believes everything can be solved with fucking cash. Fuck that dude.
That dude should come my way so that I can milk him for all he has and then block him.
Monetarily. To clarify for Twitch.
It was a joke. I literally said...
I know, but milk him for all he had anyway.
Yeah, he's a cow, right? The cash cow?
JK. The post. If you call 20K a fucking nest egg.
Wait, what? That's all he has?
That's how much he likes to gloat about having.
Yeah. That's cute. I know somebody who has more.
I know people who have a million stashed away and live in a hovel.
I'd like some money so that I can fix my house.
I would too, but they don't like to give that out because that's literally their entire life savings.
No.
Most of these people I'm talking about are in their 40s and just like, I finally bought a nice car.
I love you. But no, it's just, you know, I like to be, she was talking to me.
Rude. I know, but I am also going to involve myself because my relationship.
So? That's my personal friendship with her. You don't need to interject yourself in every aspect of her.
It's very true. I really don't. But I like to tell her I love her every single time.
You do, yeah. Honestly, like, we've had some real conversations this year so far where it's just like, tell your loved ones you love them because you never know when it's the last day.
Exactly. And that's why I do it. That's why I, even on phone calls... I accidentally slipped up and told my friend I love him. He's like, dude, I don't swing that way. And I'm just like, that's not what I meant, but okay. Right. Hi, David. My best friend since I've known him since first grade. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's no way you're not going to love that person, especially when they're still in your life.
Good. Let's go watch like a few more videos and then call it.
There is somebody who is definitely thinking about.
Oh, look, Pogstar.
See, like, look, this video right here where it says that this person wants to marry you. I've already had a conversation about this, and the conversation was the complete opposite, where they don't believe in marriage. So, this is like a prime example of me not believing what I see on the internet based off knowledge that I have.
I'm going to be honest, I don't believe in the faculty of marriage, but I believe in what it should stand for. That's about it.
Well, in the conversation, the energy and the way the conversation was just like, it's just a piece of paper. Like, I know a lot of people who think like that. And it's just like, it's the fact that you even want me to have your last name and to be by your side that matters more to me than the... ring, the big shebang wedding, because I would rather just have a small little private thing. One, I have anxiety, and I have social anxiety at that. You think I want a big old fucking wedding with all eyes on me where I have to, I gotta be prim and proper, and I have to, like, have my hair did, and no, what if I want to be in my pajamas?
I know some people who literally had a pajama wedding. It went over rather well, actually.
That's what I'm trying to say. What if I wanted private, where I just want me, that person, if we had kids, and a dog? Because apparently, in some states or country or whatever, your dog can be your witness, which I thought was pretty fucking cool and cute.
But yeah, because it recognizes them as a somewhat sentient being, and that's nice.
Yeah. My whole thing is, I would rather, if I don't get the wedding, like the shebang thing, or even the paper of it, because, like, you know, I respect people's opinions and their feelings. All right, then I want the ring and the title. Like, I want you to say I'm your wife, and I'll say you're my husband. Like, because when you're with
you say, oh, sorry, I thought you were done.
No,
sorry.
When you go. Basically when you're with somebody for an I think it was it 10 years, 5-10 years or whatever, you're legally considered married anyways. So I kind of get it. Like, it's kind of dumb to some extent, but I do get the sentiment behind it. That's where I come in. I'm a sentimental ass fucking bitch. And I don't want a person to think that they have a one up on me and that they could just run me out for my money, use me, drop me at the drop, you know, at the dime of anything, you know? Just, I want security.
See,
hold on, I'm gonna
see what I. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I'm getting almost.
I was going to the name thing, but go ahead.
But, you know, I could easily go out of my way and legally change my last name or vice versa. So it doesn't fucking matter on that part. Just my whole thing is the way the conversation went, without saying too much, was basically it was a piece of paper and that they worked really hard for what they had, like their money and all this shit. And I was like, I'm not even trying to be in a relationship with you because you have all these things and that you're capable of taking care of me where I don't need to lift a finger. That's not my point. My point is that I found a person that I connected with that's on a deeper level spiritually and physically and just all aspects. And it was normal. It was like, wasn't forced. You know those relationships where you're just like, where you kind of feel pressure to be in a relationship. And so you kind of just like scramble and find a person like, oh, they're really cute and we get along. And then you end up developing more feelings. See, it's not like that. It was just like, yeah. I actually was like, I don't want to be in a relationship. And that person was like, I don't want to be in a relationship, but we didn't really have that conversation until we had that conversation. Yeah. And again, that's private between me and that person, but, you know, one thing led to another, and it's just like, I feel like it unfolded in front of people, and a lot of people didn't see it. And it's unfortunate. But Link saw it. He saw it, like, he was literally, you know that popcorn emote, the eating one on Fortnite?
Yeah.
Link did that the whole time.
He's just over here doing the Michael Jackson meme, which is what that popcorn thing is based on. Yeah.
Yeah, he that was exactly how he was. And he's been very open about it as well. So it's just like, that's why.
I wonder if anyone else has realized that that's what that popcorn emote in Fortnite is.
I don't know. But yeah, what's up, Waldo? Sorry. He said, Luna.
He wants you to do a shiny hunt bite, dragon bite.
You mean Dragonite?
I guess Dragonite would be the right word because I literally thought there was a dragon type Pokemon that literally got the name Dragon Bite and it was just one big giant mouth.
Oh god, that'd be terrifying. Yeah, whenever I play Waldo, just remind me. Maybe on Monday I can play it. Because I'm about to get off soon. I've been sitting in my chair and I kind of have things that I want to privately go about. But hey, what's up, Kay? Good morning. I know it's on the starting screen. Just give me a second. I'm gonna find somebody.
But my going back to the thing I was talking about with the whole entire last name exchange thing. What I personally would prefer is if I get married to someone.
Right.
We're like, to me, if I get married, this is it. This is the end.
The old school mindset aspect of it.
Yeah, like, I'm not, like, I wouldn't stop the other part of mine and Ellie's relationship if we got married. Like, if she wants to bring other people in or if she's okay with me doing that, I'm fine with it. But, like, as far as the last name thing, what I would want to happen is we both settle on a last name and we both change our last names.
Well, I mean, that's a little unconventional, but I mean, hey, whatever works for you, you know?
I mean, it makes more sense. Like, two people in love, why the hell would you want to only take one of your last names? Like, why not settle on a last name together and go by that, because that's something you decided together. It shows togetherness.
Right, but I mean, to me, it's unconventional, but at the end of the day, whatever makes you and Ellie or whomever it is happy, it's your business. That's nothing to do. Because I might do something that's out of the norm or out of the, you know, the out of realm of normal for most people.
Yeah, it just, like I said, it just makes more sense to me that a union be like, you know how the Pope no longer goes by his name at the end of the day kind of thing. He is, all right, now I'm Pope Ferdinand the 45th or something.
Right. You got to change that last rule since the Discord section for looking for players was taken out. Was it? Are you sure it was taken out? I mean, I could put it back in.
Wait, what was taken out?
It shouldn't have been taken out.
The Fortnite? The thing I
it's,
made?
It's not for Fortnite. It's literally just find players. I moved it. That might be what you guys are talking about.
Oh, okay. See, that's why I was confused why Kay was asking in general if anybody wanted to play Fortnite.
Right.
Like, I was like, isn't there a section for this?
No, yeah, it's in the stream stuff. It wasn't taken out, I promise. I moved it. I was rearranging things, and it's going to have its own place. It's not going to actually be under the Fortnite. I'm going to have a gaming category. If Daisy's still here, I need that worked on.
That actually makes more sense to realm, have realm just of that game. Catch all. Yeah, like a catch-all thing and looking for players.
Yeah, and that's
the only reason I did it for Fortnite is because a lot of it's very Fortnite central.
All right, I'm gonna put it at the very bottom area, like the under show off your art. Actually, no, I moved it for a reason. It's gonna be at the very bottom. So Realm of Space, I'm gonna put at the bottom. The dark space.
Yeah, personally, it has nothing to do with, like, as far as the Realm of Space thing.
No, the Realm of Space was a category that I think Kay wanted, and it's for her to talk about conspiracies and aliens and spacey-related stuff and the nerdy.
Oh, no, I was just saying, like, she said before, if you don't like space, then fuck off. And I'm just like, it's not that I don't like space, it's just that I already have a fear of not breathing, and there's no air in space.
Right. But it could be pictures of spacey stuff. It could be stony baloney stuff, like spacey. But,
yeah, like, I wouldn't imagine that would have been gotten rid of, Kay. That's it surprised me just to hear about it. I'm like, well, a looking for players thing is kind of, like, top tier for right. Discord, if I'm going to be honest.
And yeah.
I might actually add that to mine as well, because, like, I mean, I feel bad that I didn't even think of it before, because it's literally a gaming community. Why would I not have a looking for player slot?
Right. Hold on.
Ugh.
You good?
Yeah, it's just, like, my normal morning routine
has been imbalanced.
Well, my normal morning routine is I literally lay in my bed for, like, the first hour just being like, ah, yes, I have consciousness now.
Right.
Then the next hour I'm just like, okay, debating if I want to get up or not.
Sounds a lot like me.
That's why I have my alarm set for 7:30 in the morning.
Hi! Ellie, what the heck good are you morning. Doing?
trying to get hugs from Kay.
You know, Ellie's the only one that hugs me.
You told me before you don't like hugs or physical contact, so I don't do.
IRL.
Yes, but to me, IRL hugs and internet hugs interchange. Like, you send me a hug, I feel that hug.
Just because I don't like it doesn't mean I don't want it. I wasn't raised with that energy, so it's foreign to me. Me and Kay, you know, I'm going to be real. You know how many times Kay has visited and I've sat there stupidly at my door like, is she going to hug me? Like, what the fuck? And I know it's not our relationship. Like, we've never really done that. But there's that one moment where I want her to turn around and just be like, bitch, hug me. I'm not going to see you for like 8 months. Bitch, hug me. You know, I'd give it. It's just awkward for me because I wasn't raised on that, you know. It's unfortunate. It just wasn't. But it doesn't mean that I won't give you the awkward hug. I mean, if you make me used to it, like, Aww. Nah, we hug and say I love you around here. It's like, okay, that's energy right there. We're doing this. Like, okay. I'm not gonna deny my best friend that. I'm not gonna deny a friend that, but I'm just letting you know up front. It's weird.
I usually have to hit the full spectrum of spank, smooch, and hug of Ellie.
Well, that's fine. Alrighty, before we get stuck into another, what was it, like 10-hour stream? Could you guys join me in on a little raid? I picked out a person I don't think we've raided before, but I would like to help out. It might have slipped my mind. It might have been so long ago if we raided them. Maybe Cindy may know. I don't know. But
I don't know the name yet.
I'd appreciate it. Well, no, I'm just saying when you see them. I would appreciate, you know. Nah, I don't have the energy. Look, girl, I'm on my period. Like, let's just be real. I'm in hibernation mode. You guys are lucky you got 10 hours. Now I'm going to spend the rest of the day sleeping. I got to make it up to do. First of all, I got to find something to eat. Second of all, I got to sit here and my phone is teasing me until I get my payout. Talking about, you want some DoorDash? You want some Uber Eats? You know, bitch, I fucking might. I just fucking might. But I can't do it right now. So, like, you're going to stop teasing me.
Oh.
You big old bitch. Nah, it's only going to go by what the stream is currently at, Waldo.
Yeah, you have to add up all the time.
What do you mean?
With how much the stream went down, you have to add it all up.
About 10 hours. Pretty proud of that.
Yeah, I know. I was telling Waldo.
Yeah, I'm pretty proud about that, you know. 10 hours.
The most I could ever do on a stream is 12. Like, I will probably push it to 14.
I know you don't do hugs that much, but hey, Kay, if you ever have a moment where you're like, damn, I'm not going to see her for a while, we'll just awkward hug me. I'm not a hugger, so I get it. But, like, me and her kind of already kiss weirdly because we share blunts. Is that better? We kind of tongue kiss, guys. And it's like, ooh, kinky. Not really. We just kind of, you know, we just share blunts. That's our bonding, okay? Or I try to feed her, and she sits there and goes, no. It's like, okay. One of these days, she's going to have my cooking. It's going to happen. And I get mad. Yo, Kay, you have no clue. You have no idea. I don't cook for people. I keep my skills to myself. So if I offer food and you don't take it, I feel offended. But I last time you came over, you did have a Chili's date. So I understand. I'm not mad about that. I'm not mad. Come up with a secret handshake. Yeah. I always bring my own snack. Girl, you... One of these days, let me just be a friend, bro. She over here like, nah, guys. She don't bring me snacks, but she brings her snacks. Like, where they do that at? It's not like I usually have, like, half of Walmart snack section in my room. And I do that on purpose. Because my friends be eating my snacks. So I'm like, all right, I got to overstuff this room. You know, I have a little corner by my window. It's in range all of right. hands.
I will say that we might need to alter the thing where it starts talking about the Pokemon stuff because it gets really annoying seeing Darkbot. You already have a pass.
Oh, yeah. So, wait, that's Darkbot. So, let me go actually in that. Was it Pokeinfo? It's on timer. Hold on. I gotta remove the first part.
It's either that or you just add if you want to do these things.
Yeah, hold on. If you don't.
If it was me, I'd be lazy and type in if you don't know, now you know.
I mean, I could. All right, I changed it. Yeah, I'm sorry about that, guys. I've been meaning to see, like, literally the last 2 days, two to three days, I've just been feeling, like, really sleepy. And I woke up yesterday, so now it's, like, 3 days, but it was, like, the last 2 days before today. So, like, Friday, Saturday, it was, like, well, it was Thursday and Friday full days, and then it was, like, Saturday, is when it happened. Did you page to name Darkbot? I can't rename my bot. Okay, so Darkbot is Streamlabs, I believe. It's the Streamlabs bot, and I might have. There are bots that it's not that expensive from what I remember, unless they changed things. It has its own Twitch account, and it has its own email. So I could double check. I could look into it for you. But if I'm not mistaken, that particular, like, my Streamlabs bot, I'll have to get back to you. There are bots you can rename by paying, and there are bots you can rename not one-offs. So there are, you just buy it one time. There is subscriptions, and then there's ones you can't rename, which I think.
See, what's crazy, now I want to throw this in here because
Ulta,
I do pay.
Ulta name, I can't rename unless I pay. Yeah, then that's what it was. That's what it was.
But I do pay for Ultra, and I still can't name my bot. Like, I set up an account forever ago that I made for a bot account on Twitch.
Right.
And I was using it, and then it only worked for the first 3 months. And then after that, it just started calling itself Stream Elements. And I'm like, you fucking bitch.
So if you guys want to follow in, go to my moderators. There is the Streamlabs bot. But what I think, there's like two of them. There's Moobot. I got Stream Elements. Nightbot, and then there's Streamlabs. It's either Stream Elements or Streamlabs. One of those two bots. So it has to be Stream Elements, Kay, because I see Streamlabs in moderation and then Darkbot. So if you have Stream Elements, see about that, or I can look into it. Yeah, I was thinking, Stony Baloney Bot is a long name. I would just do Stony Bot. Or Stoned Bot, something like that.
See, this is the name of what my bot is supposed to be. Like, it was supposed to be this, and then, which is funny because that's what Wolf calls me.
Right.
That is funny. Originally, that was going to be my bot's name, but it ended up being, because whenever I made the bot account, its name was too long. So I had to make another one, and it ended up being even better because everybody thought I was making a pun off cinema.
Not if you name it funny, Kay. Have you tried this? Or you could do what I did. See, my name was taken originally, too, Kay. I had to put the X for and. Stony Bodiloney. Nah, I don't like that.
Stony Bodiloney.
Bodiloney. I don't like that. I get where you're going with it, but it doesn't roll off the tongue. Like Stony Bot, I mean, or Sinnerbot or Sinbot. Sinbot.
I like Cinema more.
I like my bot. For my main bot, Darkbot is perfect for this community. The D4RK, like, come on now. I'm at 70 eggs, no shiny Dragonite. Waldo, can I introduce you to a trick that might help you? Do the 5-egg trick. Every 5 eggs, save. Hatch them. If they're not shiny, dump them. Yeah, my Twitch for it is Stony Baloney Bot. I just looked.
So Kay, you should name it the Cheech Bot.
Ooh, yeah, Cheech Bot. You can rename accounts, Kay. Stony Machokeness. Yeah, you don't own that ball. I like Cheech Bot. Cheech Bot makes sense. Because, hey, Kay, do your commands in chat real quick. You haven't done them in a minute. Can y'all, everybody who has a command, do your commands simultaneously.
I mean, my command is literally just like this.
I know, it's the Kappa. You need a sound command.
And then I also have this.
Yeah, one. See, look, Cheech Bot's good. You can name it Blaze Bot. 420 Blaze It.
I'm in love with marijuana. Makes me feel just like an iguana.
Hey, man.
I'm serious. Name it Cheech Bot. That'd be great.
Yeah, that's perfect. Honestly, love that. And it makes sense.
I would like to be credited with, like, the one-time shout-out of Sin's the guy who manned this bot name.
I want to be second because I backed it up. She has the Cheech command in my chat. It started from my chat. I like that. I fucks with it. Cheech Bot, I like it.
Whack.
I like that. And then obviously it would be whack butt for Waldo. I need to change the little demons dancing on my screen, but you know what? I kind of fucks with them.
You see, Halloween may come once a year, but the demon inside me is there all year.
Yeah, that doesn't necessarily mean that those are Halloween related.
Yeah. But I mean, those would work perfectly for me if I could actually have a fucking screen.
I want to make one of them an emote, but I would have to, like, break it. I made Spider and JP a sound command for them screaming. Of them screaming in my chat. What is it? What is the sound?
I never heard it go off, actually, Kay.
Heard what?
That command that she's talking about, I never heard it go off. So I've never actually heard what it sounds like.
I do know
if you're on console, but you don't have it running through like a PC, or you don't have a particular thing running through your bot, you can't have sounds.
Is it the thing that was in my chat the other day, Kay? When you were like, when they were yelling at you?
Alright, so that's why I couldn't see it. That's why I didn't get to hear it yesterday, because by the time I got home, you were offline already.
She's not like me. She won't stay up. She got kids.
I mean, it's fine. I'm just saying, like, I wasn't able to hear it because I wasn't able to be in stream, because I don't get off until... Like
she
my,
got two ads. She said, hold on, she got two ads. Ah, oh, man, she was the other Nate. Her and Sino, man. Sino, like, I have a thing where my mods shouldn't be naked at all times. What was funny was, out of the 60 gift subs that fucking this motherfucker Karen, man, my man Karen, sat here and was just like, none of the people that needed it the most got it. I just thought that was comical. But somebody got it today. Somebody followed me today or talked in my chat for the first time. And they got a gift sub. And I thought that was hilarious. But. San. Thank you. Now she's not going to have. No ads for you. Sin said no ads. Yeah, what ads? At this point, you need to quote that, Sin.
That's going to be Sin 3.
Yes. What ads? You're welcome. Shouldn't have said nothing. I feel bad.
I mean, I knew that she was naked because she mentioned it way earlier, but then I fell asleep.
She mentioned it like days ago, but yeah.
When she popped in earlier into stream, she was just like, ah, and I'm just like, I can't do that. I just sub mushy.
And then I fell asleep. Yeah, you were also asleep. That Shaq dude that joined and left Discord yesterday, I met him on Facebook. Oh, yeah? He accidentally left the Discord. I had a conversation with him. He said it was his bad. Shaq Gaming?
I keep saying Shaq Gaming, and you know who I think is back?
Doug?
Yes.
Doug did come back.
Yes, but I think that's him, and I know it's not.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, but it couldn't be him, because I believe he was born in 1991, and we all know
The dude is literally as old as my sister.
Yeah. I believe that's where I met him, too. That's crazy, Kay. Small world, man. Small fucking world. You know?
Yeah, I love how Discord slowly has become, like, Facebook for gamers.
Yeah, but she met him through a Twitch group on Facebook. She was just saying that he was in my Discord and he left and came back.
I don't think he's come back yet because I didn't see it. Like, I went through the logger just now and I saw that he left.
He joined yesterday, but then he left.
Yeah, it looks like he hasn't come back yet.
Nah, we were just literally messaging like a few minutes ago.
Also, I do not dislike COD NBA's thing, but like, it's very spot on.
Who?
You don't remember COD NBA, the person who's normally...
Oh, COD came from Soga.
I know, but like, normally he's in a case chat?
Is that what's been going on? I thought it was JP.
But yeah, that's where I met COD NBA, was in case chat. But I will say his name is just very spot on. That's just like, you know, if I want to, it sounds like that's what he mainly plays.
That's, I think you mentioned that he came into your chat through TikTok. That's crazy. Like,
But yeah, like, that's like if I wanted to name myself based off the games I play, it would just be Vanguard Knight or something.
Mm.
Because anymore, that's the only two games I play.
I like that he's just been spamming the snow emote and just snow angels all throughout the night. That's crazy. All right, before we keep, like I said, we're getting sucked into that black hole. All right, I do need to go handle some shit today. I love you guys.
I need to handle my shit too.
That's between you and God. Or Satan, like whatever is your poison for that. But all right, if you guys wouldn't mind joining me in on a Witto Wade, look at your messages on Discord. Which one? Where?
Probably your DMs.
Oh, hold on.
I was about to say, do you see an animated K picture?
No. She said, see? small motherfucking world, bro. Yes. If you guys wouldn't mind typing !! Raid in the chat for me real quick, please. Please. Hey, there's Ellie. Ellie came just in time.
Ellie's been here.
She hasn't been talking.
Yeah.
You and Ellie need some making up to do in chat.
We need what now?
You need what? Y'all need making up to do in chat since y'all aren't here anymore.
Oh, I thought you said something else. I'm like, we need to do what in chat?
Damn it! The person I was gonna raid got offline. God dang it.
I mean, sometimes that's a blessing because that just means we would have only been there for a few seconds and they would have ended.
So, I know who I'm going to raid. Damn, they literally...
Said no.
They just fucking ended. What did he say?
Waldo says no and then laughed.
You want to get timed out again for 3 seconds?
Getting timed out for this man is like going to the sauna. He just feels refreshed.
I'm so done. Alright. This person does not need our help, but we'll give our help. Alright. Officially ending. Alright. Cinder's gotta be quiet for a second.
Mm.
Person doesn't need my help. Remember to quack when you reach the duck. Alright, as always, I love you guys. Thank you guys for being the best fucking community I could ever ask for. If at any point on this platform you do not feel safe, I really, really hope that, not these nuts, but in this community you do. And if nobody has told you today, just remember that you are loved, you are appreciated, you are valued, and most importantly, you are wanted. Do not let any piece of shit tell you otherwise. Do not let Waldo these nuts you out of that thought. And on that note, I love you guys. I'm calling it. This is the end of my stream. I love you. Wait. I'm Luna. That's Sin. We're signing the fuck out. Love y'all. Bye.
Boy.
Bye.